Let's break down the five key phases of mitosis, which include prophase, prometaphase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. During prophase, the chromosomes condense. This means that the long unwound chromosomes are compacted until shorter individual structures become visible. Each one of these chromosomes has two identical chromatids that are held together at the centromere. Outside of the nucleus, the centrosomes begin to form microtubules, which are proteins that extend outward from one centrosome toward the other. As the microtubules form, the centrosomes start to move away from each other. This is because the microtubules lengthen, which pushes the centrosomes apart. Collectively, the two centrosomes and the microtubules create what is called the mitotic spindle. During prometaphase, the microtubules continue to lengthen, pushing the centrosomes to opposite ends of the cell. The nuclear envelope also breaks down, which makes the replicated condensed chromosomes accessible to the microtubules. Once the centrosomes reach opposite ends of the cell, they are referred to as the spindle poles. From these poles, microtubules extend and attach to the kinetochores, which are specialized protein structures at the centromere of each chromatid. These microtubules, known as kinetochore microtubules, anchor to both sides of each chromosome. Importantly, each mitotic spindle also contains two other types of microtubules. Polar microtubules extend from each centrosome, reach across the cell, and interact with one another. This helps keep the centrosomes separated and defines the overall length of the spindle. Shorter microtubules, called astral microtubules, anchor the spindle poles to the cell membrane. During metaphase, the kinetochore microtubules arrange the chromosomes so that they line up along the metaphase plate. Think of the metaphase plate as an imaginary plane that is halfway between the spindle poles. Next, during anaphase, a protein called separase separates the chromatids of each chromosome. The kinetochore microtubules shorten, which pulls the chromatids toward opposite spindle poles. Importantly, when counting chromosomes, we count the number of individual centromeres. This means that once the chromatids are separated, we refer to them as individual chromosomes because each one has its own centromere. Finally, during telophase, the mitotic spindle breaks down and a nuclear envelope forms around each set of chromosomes. The chromosomes then decondense and appear as long, thin fibers. At this point, we have two nuclei that contain identical genetic material.